An audio-only recording of an exercise session for Vision of Adventure. This recording is supported by Disability Rights UK, a fitness and body conditioning session led by Paddy Finn. Please note that you need some weights for this session. These can be as simple as 2 tin cans or 2 water-filled bottles.
So, warming up. We'll start with a bit of jogging. You jog in your own sweet way. Off we go. You right there, Liz? Oh, you're muted.
There we go.
All right, there we go. Okay, so we're doing a bit of jogging, Liz. We're
just a warm-up. I like a bit of chatting, you know I do.
Yeah. It's very boring if everybody goes mutes themselves. I'm just talking to myself. I don't know what's
going on. No, I like chatting.
Right.
Tell me about your cooking.
Okie dokie. So let's do a little bit of marching. So we slow it down, but we get those knees up and we swing those arms so that we loosen up.
Where's Linda tonight? She said she was coming.
I tried to find something more exciting to do, but failed.
So you had his session instead?
Yes. No, it's so disgusting outside, I'm not going anywhere.
When's your next holiday then, Di? Where are you off next?
Well, I'm in Paris for work in a couple of weeks.
Nice.
And then I'm going for 10 days for work.
Oh, nice. Bad life, isn't it?
Got a little bit of holiday attached to each, but...
Where's Paddy gone? Is he gone?
Just do it. We don't need him.
Nah. Is it trunk twist?
Marching for an hour.
trunk twist.
Paddy's vanished.
I hope he's all right. He's going to check his bolognese.
When he comes back home, we need to all be really out of breath.
He was eating his bolognese.
Was he? Yeah.
I think he's been kicked out.
Yeah, it looks like it, doesn't it?
He obviously wasn't marching hard enough.
My mat keeps moving. He's had a better offer. He's had something more exciting to do.
Yeah.
What else there are? Oh, arm circles.
Yeah, arm circles.
Oh, yeah.
Then trunk twists, wasn't it?
Yeah, I've done my trunk twists.
And then should we do squats? Should we do squats, do you reckon?
Oh, there he's back.
He's back. I'm sure there's something else on the warm-up that I've forgotten. Is he back? Paddy, are you there?
Right, hello.
Oh, I'm back.
We're on to squats.
Good. I'm glad somebody's doing it. I think it's a good job. Sorry, I was using Kat's computer and it froze.
We know your routine off by heart, so we're all right.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. Good. It's like I can almost do it right. Right, but what are you doing? Just counting, Liz?
Yeah, I was just doing 10 squats.
Right. Okay. So shall we stop there and then we'll get all right, you've done squats, so let's go on to split squats. So that's where one foot's forward, one foot's back.
Don't know what anyone else is doing.
Apologies for the freezing. Right. Okay. So you can have a weight in one hand if you like. Okay. And so we're gonna do this for 30 seconds and you're gonna drop your back knee down. Try and keep so it's your back knee going down rather than your front knee going forwards. 3, 2, 1, off we go. So the it's your front leg that's doing the work. Ah, right, back to normal. Hurrah. So that's 15 seconds.
Are you panicking?
Oh, I was just frustrated. Just frustrated. That's 25 seconds. 3, 2, 1, stop there. Okay, so let's swap legs. So we take that stride. If you've got a weight, you've got it in the weight is in the hand that is, the weight is in the same hand as the knee that is at the back rather than the front. Okay, 3, 2, 1, off we go. So thinking going down, right, okay, looking good. Try and go down rather than forward. Right, everybody, I can see, looking good. And you can hang on to a chair or something just to keep your balance. And you don't have to always go down, you don't have to go right down to the floor, but you'll feel the stress in those muscles, I hope. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Okay, bicep curl, easy peasy. Weight in each hand, stand up, weight in each hand. Knees can be soft. You don't have to bend them. You don't have to lock your knees out, just soft, stood up. Weight in your hand, palms facing forward, hands by your thighs. Okay, and then bending your elbows to bring your weights up to your shoulders. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Good. Your rhythm. Lizzie, are you just going to count? Yeah, you're counting, right? I can see.
Thank you. Yeah.
Now go. That's 20 seconds. 25. And that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. Okay. Right. This is our bent over lateral raise or our impersonation of a bird flapping its arms. So a couple of weight, got some light weights in your hands. Step forward with one foot, lean your body forward at an angle. You're not at right angles, but you're just leaning forward so you can swing your arms easily. Let the weights hang down, and then you're going to bring your arms out to the side. 3, 2, 1, off we go. And as you're bringing them out, think about pulling those shoulder blades together. Okay. So it's not just the front of the shoulders that are working, it's also your scapula, your shoulder blades. So your shoulder blades are squeezing at the back. Okay, and there we go, that's 20 seconds. And there we go, 25, looking good. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. Okay, so this upright row. So this is the one pulling the weeds out the or the small shrubs out of the ground. So step forward with one foot, have the weight in the opposite hand, and then pulling that arm up and the elbow going pointing towards the ceiling. Normally done one hand at a time. You can do two, but you're going to do two sets of 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, off we go. If you turn that weight through 90 degrees and then lean forward, and then your elbow's going behind you. If your elbow.
Oh, is that one? Sorry. Yeah, I was doing the wrong one. Yeah, sorry.
So elbow up.
I know them as tricep kickbacks.
Right. Okay. Yep. Okay. That's 20 seconds.
Oh, the heavier weight. I just realised. Yeah. Wrong way. Well,
and
I was on completely the wrong
end. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Oh, okay, you can get lopsided, have a heavier weight on the other side.
I know.
Are you ready? So those elbows pointed up to the ceiling. 3, 2, 1, off we go. So elbow up. So pulling that weight. So the weight's sort of coming towards your armpit, really. Okay, and that's 15 seconds. Boom, 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 boom. 20 seconds. 25. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. Okay. Shoulder press. Standing up. weights in our hands, hands either side, hands sort of resting on your shoulders, and then you're going to push the weights up towards the ceiling. Okay, in two, one, go. Oh, excuse me. Now then, it's been an interesting day. The dishwasher started leaking, so we've got to get that sorted. The conservatory is leaking, but the man's going to come and have a look at it on Friday. Hurrah! Okay, that's 20 seconds. And my computer hasn't frozen. That's good. 25, 3, 2, 1. Access. Well done. Looking good. Okay. And we're on crunches. It's lie down time. Hurrah! Hurrah, I hear you say. We're lying down because we love crunches.
We don't have the upright row anymore. That's what I was... Do we not have the upright row anymore? Did that go?
You've done that.
That was... You were doing a tricep extension.
Yeah.
Yeah, well...
Did we not have the upright row or was that gone? I've lost
that
track.
That was the upright row, but you did a tricep extension. And I... said about your elbow going to the ceiling, but you were happily doing what you're doing. It's all right.
I was confused.
Give you details next time.
I was confused.
Oh, you've got so much knowledge in that head. You see, it just got a bit jumbled up.
No, I thought I was doing a upright row, and then you told me to do what sounded like a tricep extension, so I did.
Right, I'll have a look.
You're exercising.
I will have a look with my forensic eyes next time. Okay, so first crunch is lying on your back, knees bent, feet flat on the floor, hands on your thighs, and see how high you can slide your hands up your knees. Can you do it? Can you go further than last week? 3, 2, 1, off we go. I was doing these in the gym today, and I had two young people either side of me, so I felt very sort of very focused. So I've not let the side down.
Did you get higher than them?
I just didn't. Well, they were doing slightly different things. That's 15 seconds. I just didn't want to let the grey-haired silver foxes down, you see, with all these youngsters around. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Okie dokie. So now we're going for heel tap. And remember, heel tap, you can either keep your feet on the floor or you can take your feet off the floor. But it's a sideways movement. You're sliding your shoulders along the floor and reaching for those heels. Okay, 3, 2, 1, off we go. Boom, bitty, boom, boom, ba, boom. See, the thing is, it didn't look much, but it's actually, it hurts. It works hard. Works those obliques. Yoo-hoo. 15 seconds gone already. And here we go. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. And stop there. Cool. All righty. Next. Oh, sit up and twist. So this is where we place our fingers either just behind our ears or on our temples. Don't mind which. You're lying on your back. Feet can be on the floor, knees bent, or you can take your feet off the floor and have the whole body movement thing going. Don't mind which. So you're sitting up, and it's right elbow to left knee, and then go back down, up again, and it's left elbow to right knee, or as close as you can get. 3, 2, 1. Okay, off we go. And that's 10 seconds gone. So that's 20 seconds. Only 5 left. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Good. All righty. Plank time. Woo woo plank. All righty. So roll over onto your front, either in the press up position or with your forearms on the floor, hands facing forward or pointing forward, palms flat on the floor. You can have them, they can go straight forward, or you can put them one hand on top of the other, whichever you prefer. but shoulders over your elbows. Okay, and it's 30 seconds, and it's three, and it's two, and it's one. Off we go. Only thing that's touching the ground are your toes and your forearms, or your hands, if you're doing the press-up position. Squeeze the glutes. So imagine you've got a pound coin in between your butt cheeks, and you're trying to hang on to it. Good heavens, it's nearly 20 seconds. You don't want it to disappear. So you squeeze them together, squeeze in that core. And then we have 5 seconds. And then we have 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Good, eh? Everybody's favorite. Side plank. I tried taking one foot off, doing it just on one leg and raising the other leg today. That was hard. I didn't do it very long, I can assure you. All right. So side plank. So side plank, I've got your forearm, all your forearm, so hand to elbow on the floor, pointing sort of 90 degrees from your body. And then the only other point of contact is the side of your feet, side of your foot, ideally. Or if you can't do that, get as much of your upper body and legs off the floor as you can. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Up we get and hold it there, and we got a little so moving it, getting your legs up is like it puts a lot of strain on the lower leg. Taking your arm up's a bit easier. That's 15 seconds, and that's 20, so you're nearly there and just need to hang on a little bit longer, because that's 5 seconds to go, and that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. Oh. I better do the other side, otherwise we'd be lopsided. And we wouldn't want that. Pack up all your cares and woe. All right. So forearm on the floor. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So other side. Actually, I'm for the three people I can see, I'm like half expecting you to start waving your hand at me just to making rude gestures. 15 seconds gone. Well, it just sort of passes the time, doesn't it? If you can sort of do that. Right.
That's
10 left. We're down to 5. So quick, 3, 2, 1. And that's us.
I can take your leg off the floor. Your other leg off.
It hurts, doesn't it? It's real. It's
not it hurts. It's just I can't do it without
falling over.
Collapse.
I did notice there was a bit of wobbling going on when people lifted their legs, but I was not, you were trying, so that's fine. You were fine. It's a learning process. Russian twist, so you need your weight here.
Both legs off by the end of March.
Sorry?
Both legs off by the end of March.
Oh, yeah. So you'll be doing a side plank on just your elbow, you're just your forearm.
Just your elbow.
Okay, Russian twists. So you got your weight in your hands, you're sat on the floor, feet on the floor, knees bent, and moving the weight from side to side. Big sweeping motion. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Keeping the weight in two hands. Keep the weight in two hands, and you're turning your shoulders. So if you turn your shoulders, that turns all your abdomen. So that keeps everything working well. Good to see you back, Katie. I thought you must have lost contact for us. 20 seconds gone. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Ooh. Oh, we're on press-ups already. Oh, we're flying by. Okay. Russian twist, press-ups. Easy peasy, on your knee, on press-ups on knees, making sure you've got weight over your shoulders, or press-ups with you're on your toes, not on your knees. Your choice of speed. I think going slowly is sometimes harder than going fast, because you're controlling everything. Okay, press-up. So assume the position, as they say, 3, 2, 1, off we go. And it's okay if it's a bit hard, to, if you're on your toes, to go onto your knees, or if it's just getting a bit hard, take a little pause and then start again. We're nearly 20 seconds. Yeah, we are now 20 seconds through. So good. Well done. And that's 25. And that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. Right. Okay. So this is where you can try and hit yourself in the head with your weights. Lying down, tricep extensions. So lie down, have a weight in each hand. I think it's always good to start with the weights either side of your head and your elbows bent, because then you're sort of, you've got them located. And the movement is through the elbow rather than the shoulder. So, and we're trying to straighten that arm. Okay, are we ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. And that's 5 seconds. So this is the one for the triceps.
Yeah, I'm with it.
All right, it's one for the triceps, Di.
There's so many different exercises. I forget which ones we do here, which ones we do elsewhere.
Yeah, there's so many options.
Okay. And then you have different
25 ways. Seconds. 3, 2, 1. Look at that. The time has flown by.
And my triceps will be on fire now.
Yeah. Okay, last one. I always say this is a nice one. Back raises. So you're actually lying on your front. You choose how high you go. It can be just a little movement, just picking your shoulders off the floor or a bit, or your chest off the floor. It can be a big movement if you're happy, because you can sort of bring your chest and your feet off the floor. Some people hold, some people do it fast. I'd like to just take it nice and steady and not go too wild, because I like looking after my back. Up to you, 30 seconds, starting in 3, 2, 1, off we go. We can do exciting things like put our hands out in front. We can, if you extend your arms out, that makes it much harder. So up to you. So here we go. We are now on 15 seconds. 20 seconds. 25 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool, Rama. It's rest time. Not for long, couple of minutes. Shake yourselves out. Oh, I've been approached by the Arrhythmia Alliance. The Arrhythmia Alliance, because I have my heart arrhythmia, which is now all sorted, and I'm sort of back to training and racing and all that stuff. So it's all good. Should be okay for quite a while yet, apparently. They got me to do a talking heads, a video for their national conference. Was it an international conference? Oh, I think it was an international. Anyway, conference. Anyway, so they interviewed me for 15 minutes and I chatted, and I appeared on their website for their conference. And now they got in touch with me. They want me to talk to some Italians. I got very excited. We'd like you to talk to some Italian researchers. And I thought, I'm going to Italy. Yeah. No, we're doing it on Zoom. So, so that was a, you know, okay. Anyway, so I said I'd do that. So I'm doing that in next week. And then, so I chatted to the lady, lovely Tracy, and she said, oh, would you, we've got a national conference. Yeah, it must have been, yeah, it was the world one, was the video. So you go, oh, I've got a national conference on in October. Would you like to come down in October to Birmingham? Not quite Padua or, you know, but, you know, Birmingham. Come to Birmingham, nice hotel, and come and chat to people about your experiences, you know, as a patient. And I was like, yeah, okay.
Nice.
Oh, she said, oh, or just the thought of standing in front of people and talking fill you with dread? I said, as a teacher, or was a teacher and a training consultant and a coach, I've stood and sat in front of a lot of people and talked for a long time. Yeah. So I think they'll be all right with that. Yeah. So you never know. If I talk nicely to these Italian researchers, maybe they'll invite me over.
Yeah.
A few days in Italy for, you know, pasta and gondolas and all that sort of whatever you do in Italy. Right, okay, that's your rest time. That's your, yeah, filling you with my news. it's not a very exciting life. Leaks in the conservatory and trips to Birmingham. Woo-hey! Right, okay, let's go squats. We're going to go 45 seconds if you want to. I'll call for 30 seconds, so if you've had enough by 30 seconds, you can stop. But otherwise, it's 45 for all these exercises, apart from side plank and something else, probably upright row, yeah. Okay, so squats, 3, 2, 1, off you go. So using your weight, sliding your backside, pushing your backside back as if you're closing the door behind you. I think that's the best description ever.
I've got some leaks, Paddy.
Sorry?
I've got some leaks.
Some leaks. Sorry, yes, I was like, right, that's 25 seconds. Leaks, as in leaks in the house. Right, okay.
No, as in leaks in my bed rack.
30 seconds gone. That's 30.
That's what I thought you meant.
Oh, dear. Why didn't I see that one coming? That's 37 seconds.
Chicken and leek pie, yo.
Chicken and leek pie. 3.
I just thought you were talking about your
2,
personal medical issues.
1, and stop there. that was terrible.
Ten ladies
for them.
Right, okay. Split squat. 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. Back knee going straight to going towards the floor. Front knee hardly going forward. Weight in that front knee. Have some weights in your hands if you want. Okay, up to you. And we are starting in 3, 2, 1. Off we go.
You're really going to hate me, Paddy, because literally half an hour ago, I was invited to a conference in Italy, all expenses paid, in April for a week.
But you travel all the time, so yeah, for you it's just boring, I know. But for me,
no, Perugia's nice. I've been there before.
20 seconds gone. Whereabouts?
Perugia.
Oh, I've been to Perugia. Yeah.
It's lovely.
And we're just coming up, and that's our 30 seconds, but we can go 45. So that's 35. I went to Perugia for work once. I just stayed in a hotel and didn't see much. 40 seconds.
Lovely.
3, 2, 1, and stop there. Okay, swap sides. Okay, you decide whether you're doing 30 or 45 or 40, whatever you want. But okay, 3, 2, 1, off we go. They're your legs. I don't know how much you've done on them and how tired they are.
Is that in the boot of Italy, on the heel?
It's halfway between Florence and Rome.
Oh, right, so it's higher.
No, not quite. It's a bit higher up.
I'd like to go to Puglia down on the,
yes.
Heel.
Okay. Yeah. 20.
That's really lovely down there.
Oh, I'm a geography lesson. 25 seconds. And there we go. And that's 30.
Oh.
And 35. For those who want to carry on. And that's 40. 3, 2, 1. And stop there. Boom. Okay. Bicep curl. Oh, easy. You'll all manage 45 seconds of bicep curl. Unless you've bought some new weights for Christmas.
No, mine's still at Amazon.
Well, they keep cutting staff and closing warehouses, so they could be there for a while.
Yeah.
Bicep curl. Palms facing forward. 45 seconds of this. 3, 2, 1. Away we go. Excuse me.
This is the one that might not last 45 seconds.
Well, you need to get that choice.
What size weights have you got, Di?
5K. I did already do some weights this morning, though.
That's halfway, Liz.
Thank you.
I've got a mixture. I've got 5. 2.
And that's 30 seconds if you're stopping at 30.
I've got one of those where you can add and
carry on, Liz. That was
right, yeah.
Halfway.
I've only got one.
40 seconds.
And 3, I've got some smaller.
2, 1, and stop.
2 kilogram ones.
Okay. Right, so the bent over lateral raise. So this is where we're flapping our arms like a bird. So you might want lighter weights.
Yeah.
Okay. And remember what we're looking at here. Step 1 foot forward. Well, I'll give you up to 45 seconds, but 30, and then if you stop any time after that, if you want to. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Stepping forward, lean your body forward, arms up, and pull those shoulder blades together. So we get the most benefit from this exercise. So it's not just the tops of our shoulders, but also right through.
I've got crunchy arms today.
Have you? Crunchy?
Yeah. Crunchy, oh.
Is it the damp?
Crunching.
That's 25 seconds gone already.
It's not damp and cold here, I tell you.
Is it not?
It's not the gas bill.
35 seconds. And just coming up to 40. And that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Okay. Upright row. So,
I remember what this is now. It's that one, isn't
that's
it?
That's the one. The elbow goes back. Yeah. You've got it. Okay, upright row.
Do you explain to me, please?
Okay. So, Katie, if you stand up and step 1 foot forward. Okay. So, if you step, which foot you got forward?
Left
foot forward. So, put a weight in your right hand. And just sort of, and so you lean forward slightly.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not at 90 degrees, you're just leaning forward slightly. So the weight's hanging somewhere near the front knee. And then you bend the right arm with that, keeping the elbow close into your body, and the elbow points up to the ceiling, and the weight comes up to your ribs.
Okay.
So if you were stood up, it'd be like somebody grabbing around the neck and you elbowed them in the ribs. Does that make sense?
Okay. Thank you.
Right. You and your judo background, you should be used to doing that sort of thing. Okay. 3, 2, 1, off we go.
So should your hand go straight up towards your shoulder or backwards?
It's going backwards. So your hand ends up sort of around your lower ribs. Does that mean? Yeah. Does that work?
Mm.
As if you're pulling something out of the ground.
Okay.
Yeah. That's 20 seconds gone.
I think I'm thinking of the one where you put your hand on your left knee and you pull your arm back like a tricep.
Yeah, that's what I was doing wrong.
Yeah, I can't tell. I don't know what the difference is between
that. It's more you're pulling your arm straight up. That's how I think of it.
It's like you're pulling a suitcase up or something like that.
Yeah, like you're picking
40 seconds gone.
Picking something off the floor.
Okay, yeah, so straight, like a suitcase, but... yeah. Thank you.
And that's 45. Thank you guys for that explanation. I sometimes struggle to sort of, I can picture it, I can do it, but then trying to explain it. Some of them are simple, some of them I just find complicated. Okay, we better change arms. We do the same thing again on the other side. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. Okay, so that's 10 seconds gone. It's all gone quiet. Concentration. 25 seconds. Concentration. 30 seconds gone. 35.
30, where should you feel this one the most?
Just stop there. This one, so it's working the whole of your shoulder. So it's quite a general one. So it's I don't think, unless you get a really heavy weight, it'll be working your biceps and your triceps. So it works both. So you may not go, oh, this is really hard, until you get a heavier weight. Does that make sense?
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
So, because some of these are just conditioning the muscles as opposed to building strength. So they don't, not all of them, you know, I know that, you know, when you've done all those core exercises, you'll be going, I can feel that definitely, you know, I can definitely feel that. But a lot of this is because we're using relatively light weights, we're just trying to tone the muscles as well as exercise. There will be a bit of strength gain because...
103.
Oh, you're going to get benefit from that. Right. And where do we get to? Oh, shoulder press.
Oh, stop.
103.
Shoulder press. Here we go. And so weights. Weights in each hand. Starting off on your shoulders and then up to the ceiling. We're going to do 45 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. Liz, I'll tell you when we've got to 22. So you can swap your weight. So that's 10 seconds. And that's 15. And that's 21. That's 22, Liz, if you want to swap over.
So what's your favourite equipment thing at the gym then you use?
I'm enjoying my squats at the minute.
Just squats. Leg
extensions as well, 35.
All right, yeah.
43, 2, 1, and stop there. Yeah, it's getting on stuff. It's all those other public people trying to use my stuff.
Packed at the minute, aren't they? The gyms.
Yeah, it's all a bit busy.
Yeah.
Crunches. Good heavens, we're on core stuff. Okay, so Stacey, this is when things are going to hurt. Hopefully, if you're doing lots of them. This is the bit you should be able to feel. Righty, crunches. So you're lying on your back. Don't let your weights go too far away because we need them soon. Lying on your back, feet flat on the floor, knees bent, hands on your thighs. And then you're going to slide your hands up as far as you can and try and get to your knees or past your knees or further than you were last time. 45 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. The reason we put our hands on our thighs is we can't swing them, and that because that helps us. So this should be a controlled movement, and it's just our abdominal muscles that are working. That's 20 seconds, and we're over halfway now because you're now on 25. If you need to take a quick breather, that's okay. That's 30. You can have a quick breather and then restart. And that's 35. And coming up to 40. And that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. I'm going to give you a bit of a pause because we're going to do 45 seconds to the next one. So breathe. Expand your belly. Pull that diaphragm down. Plenty of air in. I've noticed that in rugby matches now, when they have breaks, you see the guys come in and you can see them practicing breathing, deep breathing, using their diaphragms to get the oxygen back in the muscles because they're working so hard. They work ridiculously hard and they're big, big chaps. Good heavens. Right. Okay. Where do we get to? Yes. Heel tap. So you're sliding your shoulder blades along the floor, reaching from one heel to the other. Heels can either be, so your legs are bent, feet can be on the floor, or you can have them in the air, whichever you prefer. 3, 2, 1, off you go. So this is working all our obliques and our muscles down the side of our body, as well as you'll feel it in your core as well, because of that movement. And we're going to do 45 seconds because you're tough. And that's 15. So you're a third of the way round. Down through. Okay, and that's over halfway. And that's 30 seconds. We're done. 35, only 10 seconds to go. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. 45 seconds. And that's 3, and that's 2, and that's 1, and that's just really good. Okay, suck it in, breathe it in. Big, big belly breaths. Expand that diaphragm, expand your belly. So it's a bit like if you've ever done yoga. So you expand you're expanding your belly to draw the air in. So you're not actually breathing in, but the fact that you're expanding your diaphragm draws air into your lower part of your lungs. And of course, breathe out again. Have a good deep breath out. So compress those abdominal muscles you've just been
working. I've never tried breathing like that before. It's quite good.
Oh, yeah. Have you not? Oh, belly breathing.
Not while I'm lying on my back anyway.
Oh, belly breathing's really good. Really good. Yeah.
Doing Pilates.
Pilates and yoga, do you? Yeah. It's all right. It's not my idea. I stole it from somewhere else, somebody else. They call me the magpie. Right. Okay. Sit up and twist. Okay. So, yeah, nice little rest here. We're going to go for 45 seconds. You all right, kid? All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, right, okay. Okay, 45 seconds. Do as much as you can. If you have to take a pause, it's okay. I took a pause today. My first set of these took a big 5-second pause and then went again. Well, 3-second pause. Okay, three.
Sorry,
two,
what are we doing? I forgot.
Sit up and twist.
Sorry, I was getting...
Yeah,
was
so that's elbow to knee. Okay, three, two, one, let's go. Let's go.
Just so really confusing for everyone else. What was the one before? Because I just did that one.
Oh, this is heel tap. So you're lying on your back. Keep your shoulder blades on the floor. Yeah. Hands by your sides. And you're reaching to touch right heel with right hand. And then slide back. Okay. Slide
thank you. On the side. I'll untwist myself then.
I am a barley sugar. I'm a twisted piece of wrought iron. 30 seconds. Oh, dear. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. 35 seconds. 5 seconds left.
We call these something else and I can't remember what we call them.
Two, one, stop.
Horrible.
Yeah, there's a name.
Okay. Bit of a breather. Suck it in. So we're going to go for plank. So here, this is quite exciting because you can't really belly breathe on this because you've tightened all your core up. But do focus on your breathing in this because it'll make life a lot easier. Okay, plank. So either in press-up position, so you're on your hands and your toes, or on your forearms and your toes. Don't mind which. Okay, so we're going to go for 45 seconds. And we go, are we ready? No, but we're going to do it anyway. Three, two, one, off we go.
Yeah, what do they call those things?
Icicles.
No, there's another name for them.
They have multiple names. I think it's people who forget what the real name is and then make one up. 15 seconds gone, a third of the way through. Oh, so it's so easy, isn't it? And that's halfway. A little bit of shaking's okay. A little bit of shaking means that the muscles are working. Okay, try and get that breathing. Don't hold your breath. So you're over 30 now. In fact, that's 35. And that's the 40. And three, and two, and one, and stop. Good job. Okay, roll over and breathe. Woo, woo, woo.
Woo, woo.
Yeah, I did this today. I know it hurts. I know it hurts. All right, so we're going to go side plank because we're tough. 30 seconds there for side plank. We're not doing 45s. Okay, assuming the position. Four.
What do you do with your other arm when you're doing it?
You can either lie it, sort of put it on your side, just lie it against your body so it just runs down your thigh. Some people like extending them out makes the whole thing a bit harder.
Put it in the air, wave it at Paddy.
Yeah.
Make rude signs. Most people do. Right, are we ready? 30 seconds, side plank. Three, two, one, off we go. Well then, guys, you're looking good. And here we go. So that's 10 seconds. And that's 15. Coming up to 20. That's 25, only 5 seconds left. And that's three, and that's two, and that's one. Done. Whee, good job. All righty. Belly breaths, belly breaths, belly breaths. Okay. Shake the arm out, roll over to the other side, and let's get that other one done. Okay. Are we ready? Three, two, one, let's go. Okay, everything straight, get some weight over that shoulder. I find it's quite hard on my shoulder actually, just because
me too, and my elbow.
The weight's going through that shoulder and the weight.
That's my hurts the point of my elbow.
And that's 20 seconds gone. I do it on a soft mat in the gym, so that helps. 25. Only 3, 2, 1. Oh, it's flown by. Oh, 30 seconds. It was really short, doesn't it, after all
those I'm sure that was less.
No, it wasn't. I've got a stopwatch here, which I started and stopped at the right time. It's the...
Not a lot easier.
It's the fun banter that we have. The intelligent conversation. So, Russian twists.
Keep you warmed up.
Russian twist. You're sat in your and your backside. You've got your legs bent, feet flat on the floor, or you can have them in the air if you want to be. Yeah. But and you've got a weight in your two hands, and you're going to put the weight down on one side. So you turn your shoulders, and then they're going to come right over and put the weight on the other side. So that means you're twisting and using your hands. Okay. Are we ready?
Yes, we are.
Three,
ready.
2, 1, off we go.
Ready. Is this particularly Russian?
Depends what you're singing as you when you're doing it.
Depends how fast you're going.
Do you know any Russian? Because I don't. Oh, Nazdravya.
You need to drink Smirnoff.
Yeah. Is that what it is? You drink Smirnoff.
Is that what we're supposed to do? Yeah.
You spoke the weight is a litre bottle of Smirnoff. 30 seconds gone. Keep going.
Eat beetroot.
Or borscht. Let's have borscht, some.
Yeah. I make borscht in winter. I make
40
it
seconds. Three.
Cold.
2, 1, and stop. There we go. That's it. Sorry, I missed that last one. Okay, where are we? We are Russian twists. Oh, it's press up. So we're very close. We're very close to the end. You'll be glad to know. I know it's fun.
Close to the edge.
Close to the end. Dun, dun, dun. Right, press ups. You're going to do 45 seconds. You're going to have the option to do 45 seconds, should I say. Right, so either on your knees or on your toes. Yeah, you choose. Choose who you're starting. How you start. Weight over the shoulders and bend those elbows. Elbows don't have to be stuck into your ribs, but you don't want them at right angles either. You want them somewhere, you know, comfortably in the middle. Okay, are we ready? Yes, we are. 3, 2, 1, off we go. Control. Control. So, yeah. Don't make it, if you're doing it off your knees, don't make it a bend of the back. Get some weight on those arms. Okay, and that's 20 seconds. Keep breathing. This is a tricky one. It's because you've got all your abdominals, your core muscles are quite tight. 30 seconds gone, well done. And you've still got to breathe. 35. Okay, and that's 40. 3, 2, 1, stop. Good job. Well done. Stop. There we go. Right. Oh, yeah. So this is it. This will feel easy. Lying down tricep extensions. So this is where you lie on your back, weight in each hand. Start with the weights either side of your ears, and then you're going to straighten those elbows. Boom, boom, boom. Straighten your arms, sorry. Yeah, so, yeah. And so you end up with the weights pointing up towards the ceiling. Okay, we all happy?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, off we go. We'll do 45 seconds of these.
Happy.
Is everybody happy? Yeah, bet your life we are. That's 10 seconds. 15 seconds gone.
Where does that come from? Sounds like it comes from a musical.
I don't know. It's a song, I think. 25 seconds. I don't know what musical it's from. 30 seconds. It sounds like it should be a real thing, doesn't it? 35. I don't know. 40. And that's 3. And that's 2. And that's 1. And that's us done for that exercise. And back raises. We'll just do 30 seconds of back raises, I think. back raises. Right, so weights to the side, lie in your front, breathe. And you can just put your hands in the middle of your back and slide your hands down sort of the backs of your legs if you like, or you can have your hands out in front if you want to make it harder for yourself. Your choice. Feet can remain on the floor, or you can lift your feet as well as your shoulder off you, as well as your chest. 3, 2, 1, and off we go. 30 seconds. Okay, so that's 15. 20. And here we go, 25, and that's 3, 2, 1, and stop there. Cool. We are done, apart from a bit of stretching. Hurrah!
Ooh.
Yes! Okie dokie. Oh, while you're on the floor, we'll do that weighing down quad stretch that Steve Bateman does. Okay, so... so you lie down on one hip, on one side, have your legs straight out, support yourself, you know, on the lower elbow. So if you're lying on your left side, support yourself with your left elbow, of course, not going to slip. And then, so if it's your right leg is uppermost, is on the top, take hold of your right foot with your right hand. And then pull that leg up, and so your heel is going into your backside, and keep your knees together. Okay, off you go. Okay, this is great. The only person I can see actually is Bruce, and he's doing it right, so I'm assuming you all are doing it right. Okay, and if you want to, you can push your hips forward a little bit. Keep those, make sure you're keeping your knees as far as you can together. Should feel the stretch down the front of your leg. And we've done a bit of work with those. 3, 2, 1. Okay, and relax. Shake it out. And roll over the other side. Bum, bum, bum. So same thing, resting on the lower elbow. So it's your other hand. Take hold of your foot and then pull that heel into your backside, push your hips forward if you want to, and you can should be able to feel the stretch, hopefully. Three, two, one, okay, and stop there. All right, we'll do some standing up ones now, I think. Yeah, on the quads. Right, okay, we might as well focus on those legs. So if you stand up, you can do other stretch. I mean, if there's other stretches you want to do, because that's how your body feels, you want to do that. So, I think we'll do more afterwards. Okay, so just let your just soften your knees a little bit, and then just let your body drop, sort of hang down. And if you want to grab your elbows and have a little bit of a swing, and this should be a nice gentle stretch of your hamstrings and your calves. So hanging down, just let it go. And just, you don't have to reach for the floor. If you can touch the floor, great. But just let it stretch gently. And breathe. Bruce, your flexibility is good, isn't it? Right? Got his arms on the floor.
Front ways, but not sideways.
Front ways, well, that's a start, isn't it? It's a start. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and relax there. Right, so we've done sort of our quads, we've done the hamstrings. We're going to do a little bit now with the arms. So it's standing up, interlock your fingers with your palms facing up in front of you. Then turn your hands so they're facing the floor, and then lift those interlocked hands, which are facing away from you, the palms are facing away from you, up and over the head as far as you can. And I'm going to do this because I'm quite tight. So push those, keep your arms as straight as you can, and then just push. It shouldn't be horrendously painful, but you should, we're just trying to ease off a little bit of that tightness. Because we've done quite a bit of arm stuff. Three, two, one, and relax and shake him out of it. And breathe. Okay, now hands behind you, sort of in the middle of your back, with your palms facing upwards and fingers interlocked, just like we did before. And then turn the hands to face the wall behind you, and then move your hands up and arms up as much as you can, which in my case isn't very far, but it's not, they're not resting on my back anymore. Three, two, one, and relax. Okay, we'll do the signpost one now. So right arm is pointing straight in front of us, and it's at shoulder height. We take our left, that's our right hand, our left hand comes just above our elbow, our right elbow, and we pull that arm across, and so that our hand is pointing, my right hand is pointing over sort of my left shoulder, away to my left. I should get a bit of a stretch in those shoulders. Three, two, one, and relax. And if you, when you do the stretch, if you have, if your hand is above the elbow, you get a bit more stretch, because otherwise, because your elbows are jointed, it bends. Okay. And then left arm is pointing straight forward away from you. Right hand comes underneath that left elbow. So it comes underneath the arm, pulls across the arm, pulls the arm across, should I say. And get a bit of pressure on there. You can feel the stretch. Yes. So the arm is pointing over to the right. Three, two, one. Okay. Righty. Next, take your jacket in this one. Right hand goes, points straight up to the ceiling, and then bends at the elbow and pat yourself on the back between your shoulder blades. While it's there, left hand comes up on top of that right elbow, and then just gently pulls that arm down so your hand goes a little bit further down your spine. Three, two, one. Okay, and relax and shape that one out. And then we take the left arm that goes up to the ceiling. We bend at the elbow, pat ourselves on the back because we've done a good job tonight. We take our left and we put it on top of that left elbow, and we pull that, push that left elbow down so our fingers creep slightly down our shoulder blades. Well done. Three, two, one. Check it out. Right, we go back to the right arm. The right arm reaches for the ceiling because we're reaching for the stars. Our left hand takes hold of our right wrist, and we stretch that arm up. Oh, hang on. Oh, that's tight. Stretch that right arm up. And then we start to pull our right hand over towards the left, and our right hip goes rightwards. And so we're like a bendy banana. I'm sure there's better, or a crescent moon, or anyway, you know what I mean. We bend. So that pull should pull all down your lats and your obliques, which are down your sides. Three, two, one, and up. Relax and shake it out. Right, left arm straight up. Right hand takes hold of the wrist and pulls that arm even straighter and longer. And then we go up, and then we come across. So the hand our left hand comes to the right, and our left hip goes to the left, and you might feel a little bit down, all down those hips, all down those ribs, and then, that's a great stretch, aren't we? One, two, two, okay, and relax. Okay. There endeth the lesson, my dear disciples. Right. Okie dokie. Oh, it's turned 7 o'clock.